Hey my friends, a new video, and today we are talking about equipment for my two main cameras, the Sony a7 III and the Sony a6500. You know, as of late, I haven't been talking about my two DSLRs too much, which is why I was super excited when Firetech reached out to me and asked whether I want to review the new compact DSLR gimbal that they have to offer, the Firetech Scorp C. I looked at it and I was really excited about it. Why? Because this is equipment that I personally would use. It's super small and compact for a DSLR gimbal. So, and as you guys know, I prefer small and compact equipment, because if you're a hobbyist like I am, you're not necessarily getting paid for the content that you're creating. You know, you want to have something that can be easily, you know, carried, that you can easily transport, because otherwise we are spending too much time and money on equipment. At one point we are getting lazy, the stuff stays at home, and we don't get much out of the investment that we are making. So I thought this is the right gimbal for me. With that, let's have a closer look and whether that is a gimbal I can recommend to you. So with that, let's jump right into the video. So outside of the box in the lower right corner, we see the three main setting points. First of all, this gimbal can be controlled by an app, which makes it very convenient. So we'll have a look at this in just a second. Then the battery, 2500 milliampere, gives us roughly 10 to 13 hours of operation time, which is awesome. And then that extra grip and handle makes it super ergonomical and gives us many different shooting options. So with that, let's have a look what's inside the box. Now, first of all, the gimbal itself, and we will have a very close look at it in just a second. Then we have a little tripod that we can attach to the grip, so it allows us to use the gimbal as a tabletop. Then we have a small and big base plate or quick release plate, whatever you want to call them, and then a little box with all kinds of cables so we can connect our camera to the gimbal, screws and other accessories that allow us to operate this gimbal properly. Then we have the quick start guide that will give you all the basic information. If you need a proper manual, you can scan the QR codes and visit the Firetech website. Now, as I said earlier, the gimbal comes with everything that you need in order to make the most out of it. Now, first of all, an Allen key with the screws to mount your camera to the gimbal. Then we have a bunch of different cables to connect your camera to the gimbal. And then we have a lens holder as well in order for you to mount your camera more securely to the gimbal. So I have mounted my camera, the Sony a6500, to the base plates, the quick release plates as suggested in the manual, and now it's time for balancing the gimbal. There are three different axes that we need to balance: the tilt axis, the roll axis, and the pan axis. Each of them are locked, so there's a little lock that we need to unlock, and then we can start balancing. There's a link in the description below that gives you a little bit more information and a demo how to do it. Balancing a gimbal isn't necessarily the easiest thing to do, but Firetech thought about it. There are markers so you can take note how you balanced your camera with a certain lens, so going forward it's a much easier task. Once you're all done, we are ready to go. Let's have a look at the different buttons and controls here on this gimbal. Now first we have the mode button that allows us to toggle through the different modes. We have the pan follow mode, we have the pan and tilt follow mode, the pan, tilt and roll follow mode. There's a lock mode as well as a flash follow mode. A little bit more later in the video on this. And then we have also the shutter button that allows us to start and stop recording. With the joystick, we can point the camera into the direction that we want to shoot over the pan and tilt axis. And then at the top, we have light indicators. First of all, the battery status, and then there's a camera or Bluetooth indicator as well. At the bottom, we have the auto rotation buttons that allow you to rotate the gimbal either to the right or to the left continuously. Gives you a lot of creative freedom and opportunities, particularly if you're after that vertigo effect. This is the Moto Auto-Tune button to calibrate the gimbal. So here we have the power button that I probably should have started with, and then we have the AB buttons that I absolutely love. You can mark an A and a B position, and once you tap on the buttons, the gimbal will go from one position to the other, giving you super smooth movements. Here the knob function switch that allows you to toggle through the different axes, the tilt, pan and roll axis, that you can then control with the multi-function knob, giving you super smooth movements. And depending on the accessories that you buy as well as the camera that you can use, you can also apply this to the electronic focus or the focus motor. With the trigger button, you can re-center the gimbal and enter and exit the selfie mode. And then last but not least, at the base plate, the USB jacks for you to connect and control as well as charge your camera. Now, ergonomically, this gimbal is an absolute winner. The grip together with the handle gives you so much control over the movements. The footage that came out of this was extremely pleasing, super smooth, and I'm very happy with it. And then the controls, the buttons, the layout is so good that really everything is at your fingertips. I have really short fingers, and for me, it was no problem whatsoever to reach the buttons, to reach all the controls, and get the shots that I was after. So let's double tap the trigger button to recenter the gimbal, and then we start with the pan follow mode, where only the pan axis follows your movement, everything else is locked, and that makes for very stabilized and steady footage. Then we have the pan and tilt follow mode, where both the pan and tilt axis follows your movement, but not the roll axis. Looks a little bit more natural, very useful, I use this a lot. And then we have the pan, tilt, and roll follow mode, where all three axes follows your movement, makes it very natural, almost POV style. If you want to mimic a person's point of view, this is the right mode to choose. And then we have the lock mode, where all three axes do not follow your movement. Essentially, the gimbal keeps the direction of the camera fixed. It latches to an object in your frame, if you will. Regardless of how you move the gimbal, it will keep it steady. And then last but not least, a triple tap on the trigger button to enter the selfie mode. The camera turns around so you can record yourself speaking to the camera, and then a double tap on the trigger button to again recenter the gimbal. A great feature is being able to shoot in portrait mode, whether it's for Instagram TV or for TikTok. A lot of new formats or platforms are 9x16, and having your gimbal support this is great. And as I said earlier, auto rotation is such a great feature. It opens up a slew of creative executions. It's really awesome that this gimbal is supporting this. You can go either to left and right, and if you click the buttons more than once, it also changes the speed of the rotation. A fantastic feature, and I'm really glad this is available to me here. Being able to set AB marker points makes it super easy for beginners to create professional looking shots. Just adjust the gimbal to the starting point, press and hold A until you hear a beep, then adjust the gimbal to the end point, press and hold B until you hear a beep, and then if you press A or B, the gimbal will move between these two positions, create great professional looking footage. Connecting the gimbal to your smartphone is super easy. Just turn on the gimbal, your smartphone right next to it, tap on click here to connect in your FireTech Scorp app, and everything works like a charm. Very, very convenient. I found the different shooting scenarios super helpful and interesting. You have auto rotation, different panorama modes, you can shoot time-lapse, hyperlapse, motion time-lapse, and if you connect your camera to the gimbal, also track video. Other than that, you can adjust the button settings, the knob settings, the motor power, the follow speed. There's so many different options with this app here. Everything that you need is available. So this is it, my friends. This is my review of the FireTech Scorp C, a very lightweight, compact DSLR gimbal that I can really highly recommend. It has all the bells and whistles, all the features I would be looking for. It's super ergonomical, tactile, it's easy to manage and really delivers. It was very easy for me to get all the shots that I was after. And you know, it just works. It really just works. So if you're in the market for a new gimbal, a DSLR gimbal like this one here, it comes highly recommended. And I hope this video was helpful. If it was, just give it a thumbs up because it helps me and helps the channel grow. If you have any questions about the Firetek Scorp C, anything that I haven't addressed in today's video, just leave a comment down below and I'll get back to you. But most importantly, if you want to see more of this type of content of me, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so you get notified when I'm uploading new videos. And with that, as always, I catch you guys in my next video. Bye.